Sculptform products save you time and money due to their fast and easy installation and are incredibly versatile thanks to their modular design. The entire Sculptform system is built on a patented batten clip. No matter which product or material you're working with, our proprietary clip system ensures a smooth install process. In this video, you're going to learn our six-step process for installing timber click-on battens onto a suspended ceiling. This is what you'll receive as part of your order. Acoustic backing, mounting track with pre-fitted clips, battens, these can either be timber or aluminium, TCR connector clips, batten removal tool, installation guide, joiner strips, some spare standard sliding clips to allow you to make any slight adjustments, and finally, track joiners. The first step in the process is checking your reference line. This ensures that your ceiling will finish at the correct height. We're lining a suspended ceiling, so we'll be using our 45 by 32 millimeter ceiling track. All tracks come with the clips pre-fitted in our factory according to the design specifications. You need to consider a few points before you install the tracks. The first thing to consider is how the battens will interface with the wall. We've already run our line on the wall, so we're going to run our battens 25 millimeters from the wall. The second thing to consider is the overall size of the ceiling. Find the center of the ceiling. This will determine your left and right margins. You'll always align the clips on the track to the center of the ceiling so you can have even margins on both sides. Step 3 is to install the tracks. First, attach your connector clips to the back of your mounting tracks. Slide to align the TCR connector clip and then snap it in. Continue attaching the remaining tracks at the specified spacings, making sure the cantilever on each end is less than 150 millimeters, including your penetrations. When attaching the other tracks, make sure the clips are aligned. Before installing your acoustic backing, it's important to consider what penetrations there are within your ceiling. Your acoustic backing fits in between the tracks. Before you install it, make sure you cut each piece to length. Pro tip, when cutting the acoustic backing, we recommend a sharp Stanley knife with a snap blade so you can achieve a straight edge every time. Fit the acoustic backing by first inserting one edge into the specifically designed groove in the track, then bend it slightly to fit it into the other track's groove. If you need to use a tool to help guide the backing into place, ensure you don't mark the visible face of the backing. Step 5 is to install the battens. If you're working with anything except exact length battens, then you'll need to trim each batten to fit your ceiling. If your battens are random length and end matched, trim off the end matching nearest the wall for a clean finish. In combination with end matching, a batten joiner is used to align the butt ends of the battens. The joiner slides into the dovetail groove at the back of each batten. To click on the battens, make sure the batten is aligned with all the clips. Finally, lightly hit the batten corresponding with each clip. Pro tip, it's best to use a dead blow hammer to install the battens. When using a dead blow hammer, you'll notice you only need to use a fraction of the force to achieve the same result. The alternative is a white-faced rubber mallet. When installing the battens, be aware of any access hatches mentioned in the plans. Continue the installation of the battens until you've covered the entire ceiling. To remove the battens, use our batten removal tool provided with every order. Use the tool to separate the track by putting the tool's prongs into the track throat. Squeeze until one click is heard, and gently pull on the battens to disengage, and the batten will then come freely away from the track. If you have any questions that we didn't cover in this video, then feel free to call us on 1800 008 828.